Right, so welcome back to the next episode of Training the Wolfpack. And because, unfortunately, I missed one, this is almost like a double episode. We've gone for a double game. So this is like your episode 18 and 19. I mean, I'm spoiling it now. We've played a few games in between. We played a Europa League game and we've progressed and we've played well. So I think the best thing to do is give you a little bit of a roundup. So let's jump straight in and have a little look. So since the Roma game, we went on and beat Schalke 2-1. Esposito got both goals quite late on the second goal, but did pick up a little bit of a knock, and he's been very good. He's been very good since we last saw you. He's tasty. I like him. We're going to beat Cologne with a strange game. We never looked like we were going to win it. We then got two very quick goals, including a very dodgy penalty, if you ask me. But we're cursed on for Esposito. And there's a few injuries being picked up left, right, and center. I'm not liking it. Conceding a lot of goals as well. Not liking that either. I need to try and sort that out. And then we went and played Zenit in the Europa League. And this was at home, so it's like we had to travel miles for this one. Slager scored 2. Arnold scored 1. Again, very good. Just conceding goals. And I don't like conceding goals. And then we went and played at Paderborn. And Paderborn, we were cruising. Absolutely cruising. It was only 2-1, but we were cruising. And they scored a very late goal to make that smile on my face get wiped off and chucked away. But today we play Leipzig in the league. And we then play LASK in the Champions League. In the Bundesliga, we're sat with Bayern. I mean, yes, Dortmund and Frankfurt are running away with us at the moment, but I'm thinking if we just hold on to Bayern as much as we can, Bayern's going to be there or thereabouts at the end of the season. So we're pushing. So let's jump straight into the Leipzig game. Let's see how we're going to line up. So yeah, we've had to play a slightly different side this time just because of the fact we've got the injuries. So we are playing a slightly weaker side. We've got our backup right mid and our backup left back. So this isn't a foregone conclusion. Leipzig are currently sat 16th in the league. They are known for being a good side. They've got some very good players, one being Dani Olmo, one being Upamecano, one being Klostermann. They've got some good players. I like this team, so we have to keep ourselves on it. We can't drop a bollock here. So I'm trying to fill my team with confidence. I feel that we've conceded goals, but we have an ethos at the moment. We're scoring more than most, so let's just feed that ego. Let's just feed them what they want to hear, and let's just see what we can get out of this game. Again, a win is probably all that we could ask for right now. As the ball from Bekello from a free kick gets whipped in, and it hits the bar. It's a good chance early on though. William throwed in deep. It finds its way out to them, and they're on the counter. This is dangerous. We lunge one, and it's a good save. Scary. Another long throw. We like our long throws here at Wolfsburg, but the keeper comes and absolutely chews that up. But it's a bad distribution. Finds his feet at Arnold, and Arnold then, again, badly distributes that back into the box. That's probably one of the worst bits of play you'll see all season on both sides. We're not taking all the credit for that one. And after a very underwhelming first half, we go in 0-0. And I think we're quite lucky to go in 0-0. We've really not been at the races. We're going to mix things up and we're going to see how we're going to take these down in the second half. So we're going to play the three up top. We've got a very strong midfield of Kashavili, Arnold and Schlager. I like that a lot. So let's see what we can provide for those strikers. Maybe we could get a little bit more as William is injured. Babu is available, but he hasn't played much since his very bad performance against Roma. But we'll have faith in you. Come on, we'll tap him on the bum as he walks out. As they look like they're on the counter here, or on the attack, sorry, as we manage to get the ball away. Bora and Babu, nice ball out to nobody. Frankfurt are smashing by Leverkusen 5-0. We nearly get dispossessed, but again, they're relentless. They've been very good. Obviously, at our ground as well. We are meant to be the home team here. As they do get the goal, Haidara gets a goal. Very good goal as he runs away and celebrates in front of the Wolfsburg fans. And they do not look happy. They do not look happy. But it's been coming. It really has. And it's a good strike. A very good strike indeed. We demand a little bit more. We have a corner. Castrovilli, normally very good from a dead ball situation.
Hello, darkness, my old friend. I've come to talk with you again.
I have nothing to say about that. Castavini's lucky that I don't have to keep that in. We can keep that corner out, but I'm not going to. We're going to show that. That's how terrible we've been. That is all she wrote. We actually do lose 1-0 to Leipzig. And to be honest, they were all over us. We were terrible. We made subs when we felt we need to, and we were just horrific. That was difficult to watch. That was very painful to watch. We go on to the next one. We play LASK. Let's see if we can get a bit of confidence built up with that game. Okay, before we jump into this game, it is quite tight. We've only played two games. Obviously, won one, lost one. But we really could do with winning this game. Quite comfortably as well. Help that goal difference out. But we are currently level with Zenit. So, fingers crossed, Roma can beat Zenit. And we can just then push away as a kind of a leaving pack, for example. Okay, as we discussed last time, we have a very limited amount of players because we've just cocked it up big time. So we are going to play Brichello on the right and then Ferreira on the left. Get Ferreira some more game time. He's not the greatest at the moment. He's not been doing great, but I've got faith in him. We've gone for the shaft tactic. Let's hope they don't shaft us. Babi Castrovilli, come on then. Let's try again. An early goal would kind of settle the nerves here in Austria. And it's a great save by Slager. Headed at very close range there, but he's done very well to put that over. The corner comes back in, it gets recycled out, and Victoria's come away with it. And we've just swamped him there. He shouldn't really do much with that ball. He does, though. He finds his way out of the tackle, and LASK look, they look good, you know. I don't know if we not give them the credit that they deserve. 17 minutes, Brichello gets injured, and I don't have anyone else. So what we're going to do is we're going to bring Maximilian Arnold on and put him in the center there. Put him in the center there. There we go. And bring Ferreira in. Ferreira is more of a naturally gifted center midfielder attack anyway. So let's pop him in. Let's put him in with attack midfield and see what he does. Brichello isn't injured for too long. He's been really good this season. We've really pressed them. 10 shots, 5 on target. We've had 2 clear cut chances and yet to score. These are the sort of games where an early goal really is important, but unfortunately that's not the road we've gone down. Esposito gets the ball though. It's 2-on-1. Should have squared it. Why will they not square it? They need to square that more often. Surely in real life they would square that. Nice. Ferreira got a bit of space. He's gone for a long shot. That was close. But we'll take him if he's going to try that all the time. Ferreira's kind of our moneymaker. We're assuming that if he had a good season, we could sell him. If he doesn't have a good season, we haven't paid anything for him. He's free. He was risk-free, completely risk-free. Boy, Esposito, he goes round one, head down. He's been in a very good run of form, but unfortunately, Slager is becoming very difficult to score against tonight. He does not want us to score. We have a one-man wrecking band at the moment. Maybe it's his brother. Maybe Slager and Slager are brothers. I mean, have we checked that? He's Austrian. I mean, I'm assuming not. I mean, they look alike. Surely, like, they would say brothers, right? Imagine if they were. And he's just like, I'm not letting you score, mate. And ladies and gentlemen, this is where it starts to get a bit concerning, a little bit worrying that we're 0-0. And we have been all over them. To be honest, right? We're a team that scores a lot. And I'm surprised we haven't scored yet. Going to give him a little bit of a confidence booster. We're going to kick him in the butt and we're going to send him back out. Getting pizza tonight on the way out. As Boris through, can he score? Yes, he can't. He can't score. Yes, he can't. That's a new thing. And Boris to Arnold. We recycle it again. We've had our third clear-cut chances. Castrovilli looks like he's going to wind something up. Arnold to Castrovilli. To Arnold to Castrovilli. Let's just put that on repeat. Quality ball. Kevin and Babu. I don't know what his first name is. I think it's Kevin. Arnold. I mean, that was a terrible highlight to watch. They've got a chance. We head it away. Oof, now we counter. Ferreira. It's all you, son. Nice ball to Slager. Finds Ferreira. And it doesn't land to anybody's feet apart from Slager's hands. And he does very well. Oh, as I'm bigging him up. He has just gifted Rafael Santos Borra a goal in the Champions League. I don't know how to explain this. He's gone to roll it to their centre-back. He's held on to it one too many times. I like the way Borja took a touch. He's like, the way we play tonight, I want to take a touch. I want to make sure this goes in. And we do make it 1-0. With a little bit of fancy. We're 1-0 up, lads, and we're trying to be fancy. Oh, Lord. He's probably the most ginger player I've ever seen in the game. Over to Castrovilli. We're just keeping the ball now. Whipped in. Ferreira. He deserves a goal. He's played very well. But he does just graze the crossbar there. And they're still adamant about playing out the back. We've got quite a high press. And they're struggling to beat that press. Staffy Lids, what a name. Still dangerous though, 1-0. And they've hit the post. And we managed to hook that away. And this is the wake-up call. Just a couple of subs, rotate it. The tired ones are coming off. We took the non-tired ones on. That's great maths, that. That's 86 minutes. Are we going to try and just finish this off, or are we going to make this a very edgy... Oh! I couldn't even finish my sentence before Esposito. I can't say it right. Esposito gets the goal. It's a strike, you know. Bang. It's a good goal. Really good goal. He's been on a good run of form. I'm happy with that purchase, you know. Obviously, I know he gets very good in the game. I mean, it's a little bit of a cheat, but... I mean, we got to try and dethrone Bayern Munich, which is going to be tough. As Renier is through, and it's a good save. And they have come at us a little bit. They've had quite a lot of the ball. It's been very even that way. We've just had a lot of chances and failed to really take many of those chances. That's my glasses for. And that's it, guys. We are victorious in Austria. I think we should have probably done a lot better than that. I think we was a bit of a let off, but we're going to tell them it's a nice victory. Well done. We're away from home in Europe. It's never a nice thing to do. Man City beat Rangers 6-0. Ouch. And Roma did only beat them 1-0. Riquelme is out for 3 to 4 weeks. That is painful. That is very, very painful. So we are going to join you back, I believe, for Friday's episode. We should come back for the Borussia Dortmund game. They are on fire at the moment. We'll know kind of roughly what we need in the Zenit game to go to qualify. We may even qualify before that. If you have liked the video today, hit that like button. If you really liked it, be a hero and hit that subscribe button. You can catch me live most days on Twitch at 9 o'clock. The link is down in the description. Yeah, that's it. We'll catch you next time. See you later. Bye-bye.